European banking matters because Europe matters and because growth in Europe matters. And in Europe, growth is being financed primarily or predominantly or only by banks. So if banks don't have a good health, they are not disposed to take applications from households, small enterprises, startups, as today they are hardly exposed to that and disposed to help. There will be no growth in Europe of 600 million people. In Europe, banks finance 80% of everything that's happening, and only a tiny 20% is going through non-banking firms, companies. In the US, this number is over 50%. So if you are a startup company, you are a small investor, you are medium-sized enterprise, you need trade finance, you don't only go to banks, you go to other ventures, other investors. So there will be stockholders, bondholders, venture funds, venture capitalists that can finance your ideas, your vision, and ultimately your growth. The strength is that they are big. They have a fantastic network. So of course it's a weakness because they are so systemic. It's sometimes good not to be that systemic, that the single reliant factor in the equation. But they have fantastic networks. They can reach out to little villages. They have offices, subsidiaries, facilities, branches in areas where other investors don't reach. They also have a lot of knowledge. They know their customers. This knowledge, as we go to the digital age, this is absolutely critical. And banks have this knowledge. They just don't use it to really go into digital finance and use new instruments outside their comfort zone to finance growth. The weaknesses in the European banking system, I would say primarily, are the regulatory supervisory system around them. This is still not a European system. A lot has been done. The ECB now supervises big banks. I think it's a huge step. But the resolution mechanism is that when a bank gets into trouble is not European, it's still very national. It hasn't been tested. The deposit insurance scheme is still national. The big banks, cross-border banks in Europe, are not supported by, not matched by a European regulatory system. There is another weakness, which I think is critical, is that some of EU policies are really detrimental in dealing with bank problems and issues, and that's the competition policy. Competition policy at the EU level, this is Brussels policy, still looks at banks as an automobile factory or a manufacturing firm, but they are systemic, they are across Europe. You, I, people around you, your family, you have your most of your savings still in banks. If a bank goes down, unfortunately, your deposits will disappear and the state will have to step in. Depending on what is the arrangement, in Europe there is no common arrangement of helping you as a depositor to take that risk and fund you. The policy takeaway number one is you have to deal with the legacy problem of non-performing loans. This is a huge problem, it's a legacy problem. There is no European system really to deal with it. I think the European policies, again, are counterintuitive and going against the interest of quick resolution that we have seen in America with bank failures. And NPL, non-performing loan deductions. So dealing with NPLs, non-performing loans, is number one. Number two, it's really growth. Where is growth coming from? And so it's a problem of not really the banks. It's a problem of all the policy package that Europe can put together that would really foster growth, which is still not there.